right, man, let's talk a little bit more about Devin Haney, Floyd, Tank situation with Ryan Garcia. They didn't really get mad at Ryan Garcia for leaking the tape at all. Wearing the shirt and all that. The racist comments, I already spoke on that. But let this be a learning moment, you know what I'm saying, for Devin Haney. All right, people could say, well, they went around talking about how they did Floyd and sparring and all that shit, right? And running their mouth about how he retired Floyd and sparring. I mean, shit, Earl Spence, you know, pretty much ran with the story that he beat up Floyd and sparring. He built his career off that. Now, I'd rather just not speak on sparring. I'm not saying I think that was wrong. I think people that go around say what happened to sparring and do all that shit. You got to remember, what's real doesn't matter anymore. When you go to the internet, what's real doesn't really matter. It's not a real life thing. I always tell y'all this story when I was at the mall or whatever. I seen this girl on the internet. I thought she looked good on the internet because she went to the same school. I didn't remember. And I seen her in person. Trash. Trash. Went from like a 7 to a -7. So when you get on the internet, people don't care if the film is a minute, 2 minutes sparring, minute 44. They don't care about that. They don't care if it's edited. When they already got in your mind, they don't like you. It ain't nothing that you can do to change people's opinions about you. You know what I'm saying? You can pay niggas mortgage. You can buy niggas houses. You can give them generational wealth and all this shit. And you can't change that. They feel the way they feel about you. But to show you how much of a hoe ass nigga Floyd is, and a lot of y'all niggas still, you know, pedestalize him. Y'all still support him, all that shit, right? I'm talking about the black people. When he came around and he said that black people didn't help me get to where I got Mexicans did, he said that shit. Y'all ignored that shit. When he said all lives matter, y'all ignored that shit. Just think about, look at the track record, right? When he turned around and did what he did to Mickey Bay, because Mickey Bay and his cousin DeJuan Blake fell out, and he shelved Mickey Bay's whole career over something that was personal that they could have got over. Another brother he fucked over. Let's not forget when he messed over Tank Davis. When he started working with Devin Haney to make Tank mad. Let's not take it a step further. When Tank didn't do what he wanted to do, allegedly Tank wanted to go back home to Baltimore. Floyd wanted him to stay in Vegas. And allegedly, according to Paul Malignaggi, the story goes allegedly that Tank Davis, he gave Tank Davis a penthouse, a condo, you know, bought his mom a car and all that, truck. You know, for, you know, Tank to stay in Las Vegas. They said, you know, Tank sold everything in the apartment or the penthouse, bought a Benz, and went back home to Baltimore. Then what Floyd do? He starts starving Tank out. This Tank words, not mine. He said they tried to, you know, he tried to set me up versus Pedraza. That was a setup. I hadn't been training. You know, Floyd hadn't been supporting me or nothing. And he just made the Pedraza fight. Let's not forget, around that same time, he said, Todd the Boss called me from Top Rank, Bob Arum's stepson. He said, call me. I want to make the Tank Lomachenko fight. Let's not talk about how he did Tank. So before you Tank Sexuals get on here and all that shit and say, oh, man, but no, y'all forgot that? When he went on Showtime, he tried to make Tank Lomachenko. He let you know right then and there, Tank Davis was scared of Lomachenko. Oh, let's not forget when Tank Davis got in, you know, challenged to spar Floyd Mayweather. So this ain't a Devin Haney thing. Man, let's take it a step further about who he really is. Let's not forget, let's just say allegedly, slept with his best friend wife, nigga, not his girlfriend. Niggas, real niggas don't do that, bruh. Real niggas don't do that. You slept with your best friend's wife. He get you on the horn. You admit to it. Next thing you know, two lives are gone. What Floyd do? He go to the Clippers game, not the Lakers game. He go to the Clipper games like ain't nothing happened. Then he said, well, you know, I cried when I was, man, you cried. What do you mean you cried? You still went to the Clipper game. You ain't had no remorse for him. If you cared about the about old buddy, you wouldn't have fucked his wife. Out of all the women you keep around, and that just shows you how low value niggas is, man. If you got cousins, homies, I ain't seen niggas' pops do this shit, dude. That want to run behind you and mess with the girls you fuck that you mess with. Them niggas is low value. It's probably single baby mama raised ass niggas, man. And I say all that to say this, bro. And you gonna have niggas say, well, you know, Bill was running his mouth and he was a hoe ass nigga before Bill opened his mouth. How many thousands of good things that Bill said? Who was the person that got out of pocket and was it was Fag Nine? Started talking outside his neck about Floyd Mayweather, and Bill Haney checked his ass. He said, why would I? He said, I put my son around him because the man don't smoke, he drink, he a good dude, he work hard in the gym. So that's another thing why I just remain, a lot of stuff, man, I got to remain neutral. You really be wanting to help people out here. You really be wanting to help people that struggle, but you always got to remember, you could do a billion good things for people. You always got to remember this. You could do a billion good things for people, but you say you can't do something or I can't do it one time, you a fucking enemy. And Devin Haney got to learn. Now, he said, I don't think Floyd would do that. Well, less than 24 hours later, Ryan Garcia, even though he was just promoting the fight, Ryan Garcia say, why'd I tie in my Pootie Tang voice? And he know more than what I know about the dude. See, that's the difference between me and people that think like me and other people. See, when you real, bruh, you can't be around that fake shit. And sometimes it feel like a curse, but it's really just a blessing. Think about remember that girl that went down to Cancun or to Mexico with her crew? We ain't heard shit else about this case neither. And her and her girl got to fighting, and she ended up, and they went back to Charlotte, and the family had to figure out what happened, whatever, and they ain't doing no investigation. That's what happened when you keep fake motherfuckers around you. Y'all get pulled over and they say the gun yours, knowing this little Ray Ray's in the back. That's why I don't keep that around me, bro. The minute you show some hoe ass activity, some fake shit, man, I'm good. You be wanting to give niggas the benefit of the doubt, but if you wait too late, man, that could be your head served on a platter, bro. But I say all that to say this, man. What Devin Haney gonna have to learn, bro, on your way up, it ain't no friends, bro. It ain't no friends. It's, you know, people don't want to see you do good. And they fake like they helping you. They fake like they giving you game. They give you a little bit of advice. You should do this. You should do that. But what he holding against Devin Haney is that he didn't sign with him. You can talk about what Bill said, this and that. What my daddy got to do with the fuck you said? What I said, as me, as our relationship, that's my dad. I can't control what he's saying. Obviously, he doing it for promo. But what about me and you? You try to take money out of my pocket by telling this man to go fight Rolly. Come on. Matter of fact, let's take it a step further. Let's take it a step back. You tried to put a fight on December 9th, the same day I was fighting Regis Progress on pay-per-view. Come on, man. Come on. At that point, you got to step to him and say, hey, man, what's up, dog? What's the problem? You know what this whole ass going to say? Well, you know, it ain't no problem, man. You know, and he going to start backtracking. That's why you got to step to niggas sometimes. When ain't nobody around, you all together, you got to step to niggas and ask niggas, what's up, what's good? And that's what Devin Haney going to learn on his rise to success, bro. Oh, man, your daddy had money. Or you privileged, you a private school kid. And this, that, and the third, niggas will sit here, and that's what's wrong with the community. Instead of praising a brother for raising his son to be a law-abiding citizen and putting him in a position to be successful, his brother's a tennis, play tennis, right? Good, clean kid. They want to tear you down. They always want to push the poor image with Tank Davis. Oh, he's from the hood. He's from the ghetto. And they want to push that shit. But what he got to figure out, bro, these niggas don't want to see you win, bro. Your brothers, you know, your daddy, your, you know, all them, whoever in your corner, man, that's your corner, bro. How Shakur Stevenson feel right now about you? He felt like that day one. Nigga's a jealous nigga. He's jealous. He jealous. He's a jealous motherfucker, bro. And I'm telling you straight up and down. You know, you see this video, you see it. You don't. But he's jealous. I know a jealous motherfucker, bro. He's an arrogant SOB. And that's good. That's good. That ain't a bad quality to have. To be honest. Arrogant niggas get the most pussy. But he feel like, I want a silver medal. I'm better than him. I should be further than him. Maybe, nigga, if you want a gold. But that's what y'all kind of got to realize, bro. Like, y'all be thinking, you know. And you know what? And I was going to say this, too, before I get off this video, man. Deontay Wilder had a great quote. When everybody was offering to help Deontay Wilder, when, you know, after the Mark Breland thing, and now he need help, Wilder said, "All help ain't good help." I'm paraphrasing. He said, "Everybody ain't got my best intentions." That was a great quote right there. You know, all these people after the fight, "Oh, he don't know how to do this, and he ain't shit." And, you know, you see how the black people were so relieved that Deontay Wilder had lost. And the same niggas like Antonio Tarver who ripped that mother, and I fuck with Tarver. And shout out to Tarver Tate, but the same nigga that ripped him was trying to work with him. Man, get the fuck out of here. You fuck my wife, and then we supposed to be cool and go get drinks. Man, this ain't no goddamn white people swinger party, dude. Dang, come on. Come on, man. And that's what Devin Haney could learn that from Wilder, bro. Because if Devin Haney lose, he gonna face that same battle. I told you he wasn't that good. And niggas hate. Sometimes people can see something in you. Not on you, not jury. They can see something in you. I notice this with black people. They see something in you that they want to tear down. They see the potential. They see the greatness or something they jealous of, and they want to tear it down from you, bro. And you may not see it. You may just want to be a regular dude, fit in. You may want to just punch the clock, go hit the bag, do what you got to do. It ain't that he had money. It ain't that his dad there. It's something else. Niggas be jealous of anything. When you got positivity around you and you got integrity, you intact, and you good dude, bro. Black people don't like that, bro. And this is why I detach myself from the black community. I don't give a fuck what happened to none of y'all niggas, man. If we ain't cool, I don't really care about it no more, man. Because when you look at it, the most pain and suffering that a black man go through come from his own women and his own homeboys, his own family, his own people. And look at this situation. Floyd bagging the Mexican over Devin Haney. So, hey, thumbs up the video, share the video. Anybody rationalize it? Well, you know, he said this, and Bill said a lot of good things. Come on. Ryan Garcia said some whole ass shit about Floyd, too, didn't he? Well, I'm tripping, but... Thumbs up the video, share the video, subscribe to the channel, and the subscribe button, it's the bell icon button. Hit all notifications, increase your chance, get notifications. We go live and drop video. Appreciate the love and support. Hit the link tree, find me on X, Spotify, Anchor, Cash App, Venmo, PayPal, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, 09. Appreciate the love and support. Peace.